Breaking news. Sowore battles for bail. Arrives caught in handcuff. My wonderful people, it's happening. Omoyele Sowore, the presidential candidate in the 2019 presidential election and the human rights activist, the owner of Sahar Reporters, was on Christmas Eve, right, himself and some group of young men. I mean, before now, he has published it on social media that everyone who wants to protest against bad governance should come out on the 31st to protest for about an hour and a half or so. Come out with a candlelight and the placard. At the set time, guess what? Nigerian police were there, ready, and they rough-handled them, took them away, you know. And since then, they've been in police custody, even taken to prison, and they refused to bail them. Now the matter is turning another level. Let's understand all that is going on. Jailed human rights activist and publisher of Sahar Reporters, Omoyele Sowore, has begun the battle to get himself released from Koji Correction Center in Abuja, where he was remanded on Monday. Sowore arrived at the Chief Magistrate Court sitting in Wose Zone 2, Abuja, wearing handcuffs, but appeared unbothered. The court, presided over by Chief Justice Mabel Segun Bello, would hear the bail application by Sowore. Jobo, Peter, Williams, Emmanuel, Busi, and Daramola Ademola, they were arrested during the protest against bad governance on New Year's Eve and are railed on three charges of criminal conspiracy, unlawful assembly, attempting to incite others. However, they all pled not guilty to the charges. Meanwhile, the Social Economic Rights and Accountability Project, SEROP, has sent an anonymous complaint to the United Nations Working Group on Arbitrary Detention over the arrest, detention, torture, and other ill treatment of journalist Omoyele Sowore and four other activists simply for peaceful exercising their human rights. SEROP said the working group should request the Nigerian authority to withdraw the bogus charges against Mr. Sowore and four other activists to immediately and unconditionally release them. In the complaint dated 4th January 2021 and signed by SEROP Deputy Director Kolawole Oluwadare, the organizer said the detention of Omoyele Sowore and four other activists constitutes an aberration, deprivation of our deliberate human rights because it does not have any legal justification. The detention also does not meet minimum international standard for due process. SEROP added, the arrest contained continued detention and torture of ill treatment of Mr. Sowore and four other activists solely for peaceful exercising their human right to freedom of expression and peaceful assembly is a fundamental violation of the Nigerian Constitution 1999 as amended. The international human rights law, they are not forced facing bogus charges simply for exercising their human rights. The human rights group called on the UN working group to request the Nigerian government to immediately investigate and hold accountable all police officers and security agencies suspected of this responsibility, the unlawful arrest, continuous detention and torture, and all ill-treatment to Mr. Omoyele Sowore and four other activists. SEROP also called on the working group to request Nigerian government to award Mr. Sowore and four others acquitted for the violation they have suffered and as a result of the arrest should be paid some ransom. So this is what is going on presently now as we speak. Nigerian government has detained Omoyele Sowore and he has appeared to court. For him to even be released, they said he had to appear to court and explain why he should be released. Now, according to Nigerian Constitution, there is nothing holding anybody back from a peaceful protest. If you feel it's your right, if you feel It's due you, and there is nothing holding you back. If you want to draw your attention and make your voice be heard, there is nothing wrong if you go on a peaceful protest. So long as you do not break the law of the land, it does not lead to anything that will violate the fundamental human right, lead to death or whatever. It's 200% acceptable, not just in the Nigerian constitution, but also in the human rights across the world. Omoyele Sowore and four others came out on the 31st of December to say bad governance by this administration is too much, and they just want to protest, bring an awareness on what is going on right now. But guess what? They were arrested. And the arrest, they came in handcuffs. The arrest is unwarranted. Is not, I mean, there is no basis for it. And, you know, to the extent now that they are using superior power against them, putting them under. They came out and they said the bad governance is too much. Buhari's administration has failed Nigerians. And of a truth, not because they came out, it is the true state reflection of what is really happening in this country. There is bad governance and nobody can turn a blind eye to it. The way people are suffering, not to mention insecurity. In fact, that's another bone for serious contention, and Nigerians are the ones suffering it. Why they get all the kind of protection around them? So this is what is happening today. So they came out, they organized themselves. The message has been on social media. If you are not happy with what is going on, please come out, and then the description and where they'll be meeting has been on, you know. And guess what? By the time they got there, Nigerian army were there. They arrested them, maltreated them. You can understand. You know Nigeria now. You know the level of maltreatment. To prove to them that, you know, to put to the youth that you cannot stand up. If we tell you to sit down there and you try to stand up, we will intimidate you. And that's exactly what they are doing. So they've gone ahead now and making Nigerians, you know, feel like, you know, they cannot stand up. There is no voice. Putting Nigerians down and intimidating them. Intimidation is a bad game to make it look like you have no voice. You know, is another form of slavery where you are being oppressed, but you cannot lift up your head. You must stay down. You cannot speak, and you must keep it so. So this is the present state of what is happening in this country. And Nigerians are watching. You know, there is no basis for the arrest. Did they constitute any nuisance? No. Did they touch anybody? No. Did they destroy any property? No. Were they standing in one corner? Yes. Carrying placard? Yes. We're tired of bad governance? Yes. What else? So you see that there is serious injustice in the land. Leave us a comment. God bless you. Bye for now.